Okay, so range and domain. So this builds quite a lot on functions that you looked at last year, and going into a lot of sketching as well, and transformation. So first up, we'll define what these words mean. So the domain. Domain is the set of possible x values that a function can take. And normally that's actually defined for you in the question, so normally they give you the domain and expect you to use it. So normally given in the question. Okay, the reason the domain is normally given to you is because our functions we put in x, x is the independent variable, remember, and x is our domain. So if we align those together. Alright, so normally the questions are about finding the range, and that again is because we're looking at the dependent variable with our range, looking at the y values, so trying to find out what the x values, what happens to them after they've gone into the function, and given us our set of y values. So the y values are called the range, which is the set of possible y values that a function can take. So, usually asked to find this. So, range, y, and domain is x. Quick, easy way to remember that is D comes before R in the alphabet, and X comes before Y in the alphabet. So domain is X, and range is Y. So if you remember that, you won't forget which one relates to which. Okay, as a kind of three-step guide to working out the range and domain, or working out the range based on the domain, step one is going to be to sketch the function. And normally it's going to be a function that you met last year in your AS, but with one or more transformations on it to make it a bit more difficult. So sketch function, usually a function with one or more transformations. Part two, or step two, is going to be apply the domain to that sketch. So basically cross out anything that you're not allowed. Remember, domain is a set of the x values. So we're going to cross out any x values that aren't included in the domain that the question gave us. So apply any domain constraints. In other words, we're going to cross out values not included. Cool, right, when you've done that, you should just be able to read off what y values your function and your domain are going to let you have. So step three, read off the allowed y values. That's easier said than done. Sometimes you might need to find the minimum points or maximum points. You might need to look for asymptotes as well. But basically, by hook or by crook, try and read off what y values are allowed in this function. So it may involve finding min, max points, or asymptotes. So that's pretty much it. Domain is x, range is y, always sketch the functions, Be careful about the transformations. Again, the order of those directly around might change how the sketch looks. Apply any domain constraints, so cross out the x values that you're not allowed or that aren't included in your function. And read off which y values your function is allowed to take, which might involve min-max points or asymptotes.
Cool, let's try some examples.
Okay, so we're going to do an easy example of this. So we're asked to find the range of this function, and we're told x is greater than or equal to 1. So this bit here is our domain. It's been given to us by the question. So step one is going to be to sketch this function. So it's a quadratic. It's been written out in the completing the square form. So we can easily spot what the minimum point of this quadratic is. So we've got a minimum point at 2, 3, so let's put that in as well. So there's 2, that can be 3. Lovely. And we're told here a constraint is x has got to be greater than or equal to 1. So if I put 1 in on here as well, what that means is we can just forget all the x values less than 1. So dotted line up to there. And we cross this out, or literally. Cool. All right, so our range is going to be the y values that we are allowed, or the y values that are described by my sketch now. So you can see our lowest y value is here, and the quadratic is going to go on up to infinity. So basically, we get anything greater than this value. And what value is this? A lot of students, the common misconception is they think, okay, y is greater than equal to 1, put 1 into the equation, and that will give us this value. If you look, we've already worked out that our minimum point is when y equals 3. So this is going to be greater than 3 because it's obviously not the minimum point. So our lowest y value available is 3. Greatest value is infinity. So our range for this one is going to be f of x is greater than or equal to 3, less than or equal to infinity. Or we could write that f of x is greater than or equal to 3. Or y is greater than or equal to 3. Cool. So, harder example, we're going to try and find the range of y equals cos x plus 2. It's the same three steps as last time. So, step one, sketch it. Step two, apply the domain. We haven't been given one, it comes out in a minute. And step three, find what y values are allowed. So, sketching this one is going to be a cosine wave that has been moved up by 2. So these are pretty tricky to draw sometimes, so I'm going to kind of cheat and put some markers in. So there's going to be 1, 2, and 3. Now cos we moved it up to, cos normally starts at 1, goes down to 0, and kind of oscillates around the x-axis. Because it's up 2 though, I'm going to pretend we've moved our x-axis up 2, and now I'm just going to sketch it here instead. So it starts at 3, down, it's not too bad. You can get rid of that line if you want. There you go. So we've got 360, 180, or 2 pi and pi if you're that way inclined. So we need to find out what the range of this is. Well, we haven't been given a domain. We won't always be given a domain. This actually just keeps repeating, so it's not going to change outside of this domain that I've drawn anyway. So what's our maximum y value? 3, what's our minimum y value? 1. So our range of this is going to be between 1 and 3. So straight away we can say that f of x less than or equal to 3, because it can equal it greater than or equal to 1. Or we could say y less than 3 greater than or equal to 1. Wasn't that hard, was it?